Negotiations between all city worker unions and the city of Memphis are at an impasse.
And here this morning to discuss what's happening, Thomas Malone with the Memphis Firefighters Union. And Mr. Malone, always glad to have you back on Live at 9.
Thanks for having me.
In recent days, we've heard you use language saying slap in the face, a joke. Why do you feel that way about the talks?
Well, I mean, when you look at that 30-something years of past practice of what's been going on with what we would call contract negotiations, and with this administration, I really use caution calling it contract negotiations. But there's a system that's been set up, and this organization, this group here that's in office now, they're politicians. They're not actually city employees as they should be. And now what they're doing is they're desecrating the whole system by just ignoring it. And so when you look at that, and the citizens spoke in 1978 at the poll. So this mayor and this administration doesn't have the right to go against the will of the citizens on what they wanted. There was a system put in place that would stop anything that happened in 1968 and everything in 1978.
So give us an example of what you mean when you say you're reluctant to call what's going on negotiations. There's no, well, what policies that were put in place are they ignoring in your view?
In the past, we would set up what we would call the negotiation process.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And we would go to the table and we would set ground rules on how we would do things, how we would meet, all these intangible things that have been done for 30 some odd years.
Right.
And this year we get a call and we have a meeting that, hey, we're not gonna give you anything, there's no sense negotiating. If you got anything you want to present, you can give it to us in writing. So you have to understand, it would be like you're sitting here with trying to do the news and there's no news.
Mm-hmm.
You got to try
mm-hmm.
to make something up as you go along.
But at the same time, we've heard George Little say, the city's chief administrative officer, saying the reason they did it this way is it puts everything right there on paper and it's black and white for everybody to see. So there won't be any confusion. I take it you don't agree with that.
Oh, no. It's always been in black and white. You exchange proposals in black and white. You put them in writing. We double space them. We put our explanation on paper. We hand it to you. You study it, you come back and say what's right, wrong, or indifferent with
right.
it. We go back and forth and come to a result. The intentions come to a result.
What you're saying, it sounds like, is that they're giving you black and white and saying, here you go, this is it,
well,
and there's no conversation back. When we heard Mayor Horton say, I wish there was a pot of money, your reaction was to laugh. You actually say that there is money that they are not disclosing. Would you go so far as to say they're lying?
Yeah. Well, I would say lying is a strong word.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to say that they're putting out misinformation.
Okay.
I'd like to be a little diplomatic about it.
Okay. In what way specifically?
Well, number one, have you ever seen a capital improvement budget that's proposed to the city that they haven't done in this administration? Number one. Number two, have you ever seen when they want something, they want three more city attorneys? Boom. They want a new CAO? Boom. When you do things like this and you see money and they say, well, it's not one-time money. No, it's reoccurring money.
Let's flip this, if you will, just for a little bit here. We've heard some city leaders, though, say in the past week or two that if the fire union, if the police union, if you guys got everything that you want, it would amount to almost $41 million, I think was the quote. Do you agree with that figure? Is there an area, though, Mr. Malone, that you folks can cut?
We cut, Alex, what we did. And speaking of misinformation, that's what really upsets us. The citizens of Memphis are our customers. In essence, they're our customers.
Mm-hmm.
And this administration lied to the customer. I'm going to use a strong word. They lied to the customer.
How?
That's not $41 million. What they did is they took this money and they exaggerated it and made it look like that it was a one-year request. The original request was over 3 years by all the unions. Now, what the city did then is they took all the city employees, including the directors, the mayor and his staff, and everybody, and included them in our proposal.
Making it sound like they were part of the firefighters
exactly.
union and the police
and,
union.
Exactly, and we have what is agreed to a bargaining unit. When we run our numbers, we have a set number that we run them for.
Mm-hmm.
And so we can't control. It's really a shame that this administration is playing politics to its highest level by putting this out to the citizens and saying, hey, they're trying to rob you and trying to gouge the system. When in essence, our last best offer the fire. That's all I can be responsible for. Our last best offer for this budget was actually less than $100,000.
I do want to ask you very quickly here, of course, a new, the mayor has appointed a new chief administrative officer, Jack Sammons. Are you more optimistic with the business approach that he brings to the table that negotiations might improve, or what do you think things could stand there?
I really don't know how much, and I respect Jack very, very much. I've known him a long time. I'm not sure that, you know, the way I look at George Little, he was doing what he was directed to do. I'm assuming that Jack will have to do what the mayor. So, that's hard for me to say. Political-wise, the mayor's posturing through politics. I think this, to say that there's no money, we've given away over $40 million in corporate welfare. We just found $9 million for IKEA. We've given over $40 million for fixing open Bass Pro. None of these things are bad, but at the expense of the people that are running this city, the employees, that's what really bothers us. This administration has never given these people one nickel in their whole time. They never can find any money, and they never will find any
money. Quickly here, no talks today. They resume when?
My understanding, we're through as far as talking with the city under the impasse ordinance. They can come back and accept our offer, or we can accept some of theirs. But
so there's
we'll
a cooling off period right now. What would happen? What will happen next?
Well, we'll go and give our last best offer to the chairman of the council the day after the cooling off period under the impasse guidelines, and then he'll choose some impasse committees for all the unions.
Okay.
And we'll actually do due diligence before the city council, what we should have been doing over here with the city.
All right, Thomas Malone, thank you very much for your time.
Thank y'all for having us.
Thank you very much.
All right.
All right, next on Live at 9, a Memphis woman receiving some high accolades nationally.
Yeah, she's been honored nationally. After this break, we talk to Dr. Melissa Collins and find out what motivates her to success.